The fleet has been eliminated by Silkworm radar, several shipborne radars, and we have also detected Bear and Backfire bombers capable of anti-ship missiles incoming. The news on land ain't any better. SA-11, SA-2 SAM sites have gone active all over the country, and satellites have detected significant military buildup at Sochi. Due to the suddenness of these events, the fleet commander has opted to pull the fleet out of harm's way and push southward toward Georgia under the cover of fleet-based assets, while the fleet pulls back land-based assets will attack the airbase at Sochi, upon completion of which they will then assess with defense of the fleet. So basically, to execute this, basically it's going to be two different fronts today. I'm going to be doing this. Basically, fleet-based elements will primarily be tasked with providing cover for the fleet during withdrawal. Tomcats will perform long-range interception of any and all incoming aircraft that they will target, destroy, bombing aircraft. Katsunami, what the hell are you doing? Thank you. Murdoch. I'm trying to read here. After which, they'll provide air cover to naval strike aircraft. The Hornets will be performing anti-surface warfare against the detected surface contacts. Their priority shall be the missile boats in the area. There are four of them. After which, they shall join the Harriers in their strike mission, which will be the destruction of the Silkworm batteries along the Russian coast. Once a fleet has been secured from Russian aggression, the naval units shall detach and assist the landborne units with their operations, if there's anything left. Right, now this concerns you guys. Land-based assets will conduct a preemptive strike on airfield and the Russian army massing near the Russian airfield of Sochi. So Fishbirds and Falcons shall provide air cover over the target zone. The Eagles, the Falcons, and Mirages shall fly a long-range air patrol to provide air superiority and cover for the Warthogs and JS-17s. Warthogs will fly primarily along the coast to destroy the closest silkworm batteries. And what the fuck?
That's great. Whoever the fuck did that.
What the
hell? Top notch.
She did not grow that ass.
That's a very beautiful picture of you, Wolfman. I appreciate
it. I got a lot more.
That's a squadron commander. I'd follow into hell and back.
Anyhow, where was I? Warthogs will fly along the coast and destroy the closest silkworm batteries to assist the fleet. And then.
What the fuck? Who's doing that?
Oh, yeah, who's doing that? He says with Murdoch and Big Blue there. Yeah. Indeed, gee, man. I wonder who the fuck does that. Very stealthy, Murdoch. Good job.
I just need a laugh. Sorry, guys. Go on.
That was good.
The Warthogs will fly along the coast and destroy the closest silkworm batteries. So basically, you'll find on to North Sochi, there are three silkworm batteries up there. Warthogs take care of those ones. And then basically come back and basically level everything that they can find. Now, JF-17, your tasking is primarily anti-radiate, radar or seed, or whatever you want to call it. Okay, so order the battle. Gain, Tomcat, Nimitz 1-1, that's me. Alright, land-based assets. Your commander is Mirage Bonaparte 1-1, followed by Falcon Patton 1-1, and then A-10C MacArthur 1-1. After that, you can fight amongst yourselves.
I was wondering what you asked me about Bonaparte.
Oh, yeah, okay. So
at least it's more original than Baguette 1-1. I appreciate that.
Yeah. Is so essentially everyone's gonna pretty much do their own thing in terms of
basically. All right. So basically, the way I worked this one out, because I was expecting more people, and so basically there's a naval element and there's a land element to this mission today. So all you guys taking off from the land-based strips are going to be hitting Sochi and then working your way up. Once you've done that, then you come up and help the Navy.
Cool. So pretty much take off, go, destroy Sochi,
yep.
And then after that, are we gonna be meeting with the Nev?
Yeah, because I've got a fair bit to do up there.
By the way, I'm not on this. JF-17, last car.
Yeah, because the JF-17 is not, because this is just the first three steps in the order of battle. So,
okay. So I don't get a call sign?
He's 2OC. He's 3OC. I'll tell you what, if you can shoot down anybody else who wants, you know, sort out like walks.
Okay.
Yeah, give him a nickname and put him there, otherwise he'll cry.
Yeah, exactly. I'm already tearing up. I don't know, yeah, Confucius 1-1, whatever. The fuck is Taizong?
Taizong? What the heck is Taizong?
He's some Chinese general. It's a Chinese knockoff of an F-16, so it's got a Chinese general.
Alright. It's less cool than Patton or Bonaparte, not gonna lie. Bing Lao.
call him Boink 1-1.
Something wrong.
What the fuck?
You seen that fucking news thing? Holy fuck, we too low. Ben Ding Ow. That news report is beautiful. Alright, I'm holy fuck 1-1. Let's go, boys.
Okay, radio presets. So basically, Naval Freak, screwed that. We're all going to be on 270. GCI be 129. Oh, back on the previous page. Yes, we do have tankers in the area. It is the Tactico and Arco. Tactico is a regular KC-135 on 89 Yankee, Radio Freak 251. Arco is the MPRS variant on 95 Yankee, call sign Arco on a Freak 250.
We might just write it down, people will forget. 251 is?
251 is Texaco, and they're on 89 Yankee. Put that in.
What's the tech again? 89.
It
says it on the bottom right. To 270.
Bottom right, where? Is it already there?
Bottom right of page 6.
Sorry. I'm writing shit here, but never mind. I didn't see that. My apologies. Go on, Mo.
That's right. All right. As I said, we won't bother with the Naval Freak at 260. We're all just beyond bucket. We'll just go 255 like we usually do.
Yeah, just a heads up. JF-17, if I want to have data link, I can only have one radio.
Okay, cool. Now, important tip from...
We had some issues last mission with the J-17 as well. My recommendation to you is probably... Can you use the SIS external stuff? There are some external features you can use. What's it called?
Is that a thing?
Yeah,
audio
so...
expansion, I think.
Yeah.
Wait, what is it called?
Audio expansion. I think it's on. Let me check real quick.
Audio expansion allows you to expand the radio like if you were in Flamecrest 3 aircraft, and you can pretty much use all the frequencies.
Like a million radios. Okay, that's awesome. How do I turn that on?
Should be toggle radio overlay or something like that.
Yep, the toggle radio overlay right underneath the connect button.
Okay, and it just lets me do whatever the fuck I want. All right, awesome.
Okay, so where are we? Yep, so, yep, 255 and tap GCI main overlord 2129.
Copy that. So, main frequ- cool, sounds good.
Alright, this concludes the briefing. Any questions?
No questions at all. Pretty much, we take off. I head to Sochi, blow the shit out of Sochi. And, after we get finished Sochi, what we're doing again?
Okay, so basically, if you finish the Sochi before me, you follow Takan 7-4 X-ray as the carriers Takan and help with defense of the fleet. There's two tankers, the Texaco and Arco, are at about the halfway point if you need fuel.
Oh, okay, so essentially finish the Sochi, head to the Takan X-ray, and we defend the...
Help defend the fleet, because, yeah, the whole idea with this one was, like, yeah, the whole, like, timing about, you know, landing, rearming, refueling, taking off in lulls of battle and shit, but let's say it's not...
That's fine. In terms of, me ask what's going to be the distance we're going to have to fly today, and what's the distance between Sochi and a carrier, and
So the carrier's about 200 miles away from Sochi. That's why it's in the tankers.
Cool.
You'll be taking off from Guadada.
So take off Guadada, hit Sochi, fly to fly to the tankers at on the ocean.
Yep.
Once we call, how's that gonna work? Like, because that tank is probably going to spawn when you get by, right? So is a trigger there?
No, it's already in game. So if it gets shot down, you're screwed.
Okay, so defend the tankers to stay alive. Copy that.
But that said, the tankers are well outside the air field of battle anyway, so they shouldn't come into too much of a...
Copy that. Do you have an estimate how long do you think we'll be taking to finish at Sochi?
Don't know. There's a fair bit there to blow up.
By the way, I'm the only one running seed, correct?
Correct.
All right. What kind
I
of?
I could do this as well.
What kind of what kind of SAMs are we expecting over there?
It should be two SAM batteries at Sochi, SA-2s, I think.
Ah, easy, dude. I don't even need anti-radiation missiles.
What do you fly, Madfish?
Probably the foot.
Well, oh, that's what I would have never guessed.
Included in the mission. Fuck, my Oculus software is going crazy.
Call 1-1.
Yeah, I have a concern. I have never refueled in air before.
Okay, well, yeah, that's the great thing about the Guadada being so close to Sochi. You can refuel from there. That probably added like another 10 miles to your flight time.
Nah, he's going to refuel from the air. We have to learn. Like, everyone sucks. And the worst you can do is die. All
right. So server's already up.
Yeah, so it was already up. I was gonna start.
Cool. It's paused though, but yeah.
Yeah, I'm at the page right now. I'm about to hit the play button.
So do you have a plane for Madfish there, right?
Yeah, the 2050s.
Cool.
Is SU-25s in there?
Cool.
I love this SRS auto connect now. It's so considerate.
There is one interesting blue player already connected.
Gee, I wonder who that is.
Yeah, is somebody already connected?
Yeah, me.
Oh, the out connect is great. And, not the, not only the out connect, but the auto update.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Like no more going through website and shit. I just press one button and everything does to you, which is great. I like I'm waiting why they just don't integrate everything to DCS itself. Much easier. I'm already in game. Everything seems to be unpaused. So what's it called?
It's called fallback on the mission server.
I mean, like, are we starting now? Can we get in the cockpit?
Yeah, get in the cockpit, start up, and see how it goes. And let's... Yes, it appears to be running already. Oh, shit. That means I already have backfires incoming.
Do you want to restart? It's fine. Can they restart?
Yeah, in that case, let's just restart, I guess.
Okay.
Alright, disconnect.
Oh man, my computer just crashed. Give me a minute. Hey. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I shouldn't have
raised. Do we want to restart or what?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, go for it. His computer crashed.
Yeah, it froze.
Get it a heating blanket.
Hey,
yeah.
That's a funny joke. I swear, if I have to rebind all my fucking things because DCS is a fucking retard, I'm gonna kill myself.
That's alright. Don't have to kill yourself.
No, I will genuinely commit suicide.
So, Madfish. Can we, like, unpause it from inside the server? We'll have to go to, like, the server page and push.
No, that should be able to pause the mission from the interface online.
Yeah. Oh, my God. The interface online is the only way to go right now, but maybe they will add some more stuff later. But right now, it's the only way.
Okay, interface online, right now.
But I think the interface line works pretty well. Everything's frozen.
Much better than what we had before, right?
Yeah, totally. Murdoch is here. Is it sunset or sunrise?
Sunrise.
Sunrise. Interesting. Gonna have a care launch like Top Gun. Speak of Top Gun, I'm so keen to watch that movie.
Do you know he's not keen for Top Gun 2? Anthony Edwards.
I'm keen.
Who the fuck is Anthony Edwards?
He's the guy who played Goose.
Oh, right, because he's fucking dead. Makes sense.
Goose is not dead. It's just went
holding. Goose is mega dead.
So his son is in the movie, and so see a lot of drama as usually, and people.
Oh, his son is in the movie.
Yeah. His son's one of the pilots, but he's Tom Cruise's training.
Okay.
Well. Son of Goose.
How big was Goose that he had his own son?
Say again?
Never mind. It was an astrology joke.
Oh,
very sorry. Nice.
It went over my head at warp 9.
Are we gonna stay in the briefing panel, or are you just gonna connect to the call?
Well, I've already connected to the cockpit on the air, so I'm just waiting to get the go-ahead to unpause.
Alright, who is here not ready?
Me, because I'm binding shit, but don't worry about me.
And we have to worry about you.
I'm not ready either. Give me a minute.
We've got to have holy fuck.
You can't do it without a holy fuck.
Okay, so it's official.
I mean, if I had another 15 minutes,
next mission. Next mission, Will's nickname will be Wait a Minute.
I know, right? It's not going my way right now. So it looks like I tried to log on, and you know, I had my password automatically log on, but my username or password's not in there, and I don't remember what my password is to log on to the server. Oh man.
The server itself is just Delta all lowercase.
I'm sorry, not the server, but on DCS. You know, when you log on to DCS,
oh,
I always
you're
have
a
it like
DCS user.
Yeah, it's deleted. I always had it like, you know, automatically log in to save, and I haven't touched it for over a year. And I'm like, I don't remember that crap. So I'm trying to reset it, my password.
Yeah, I think just go to the DCS website and use their password reset.
Yeah, that's what I'm working on right now.
Come on, guys. It's 30 minutes past.
Come on. We'll shoot some shit.
We need to go fast. Last car is going to come in suicide.
I mean, I've got an entire squadron of SU-33s bearing down this carrier. Jess is going to get so worked up.
I guess we don't need this night vision goggles, eh?
What's that, night vision?
I guess we don't need night vision goggles.
Oh no, the sun's coming up. It's a pre-dawn raid.
Who's this? Sun is coming up.
Correct.
Yes, you're pretty free.
Here comes the sun.
That's pretty gay.
Sunrise early in the morning. Is it too soon to start singing rock?
So who are we waiting for?
Someone. It's hacking.
Last Karen Will.
I'm getting in. I actually rebound pretty much everything.
Okay, now it's just Will.
Fucking hell, Will. You suck.
I'm telling you, it's not going to be. It is bad.
Well, let's hope you have still access to the email you used to.
Oh no, I only have one email account. And it said
that's never a good thing.
Yeah, and so it says you must add our eagle.ru domain to be safe senders. So I added it to my domains list, and I'm still not getting an email from them. So
how the fuck did you forget your password? I just want to say this.
Because I haven't logged on to it in over a year. I always have it as save and automatically log in. The question is, where did it go? Why did it all of a sudden delete itself?
Yeah, it's DCS. You gotta expect the unexpected.
It's like, why would it do that? Man, so I wonder if I have to create a new account or something.
Well, you can't, because all your modules are tied to the account, so you can't.
Oh no! I did it on Steam. All mine's on Steam. I'm like that.
Oh
that
wait,
guy on Steam. Yeah.
Didn't it like auto log on?
Yeah, it's usually I never had this issue.
Oh, so you forgot your Steam password?
Oh no! I'm on Steam with no problem. The problem is
so what the fuck is happening?
You know when you first log on to DCS? When I log on to DCS on Steam, I had to create an account on DCS's webpage, and it makes you log on using that. So it's something I set like over a year ago, and I never had to use it again. because Steam, you know, I got all the stuff, but it you don't log on with your Steam password. You use it to start the game, and then there's a log on. And if I want to play online, I have to create an account on a DCS, basically.
Okay. So what stage are you?
Okay, I'm just putting it out there. I'm pushing the play button in 4 minutes.
Yeah, go for it. I mean, like this sucks. I'm like pissed.
Keep trying, man. That's all you can do. Try reset the PC, because sometimes what happens is because it has crashed, things probably not recognize the save games folder, and that's why you cannot see this stuff. Maybe do a quick restart or something. Keep accessing your email through your phone meanwhile, and try to make things happen.
Yep, I'll be back real quick. I apologize.
Once. Are you still there?
Yep, I'm still here.
Okay, one more thing. The domain you need to whitelist is digitalcombatsimulator.com. That's where you get the email from with the password change request. Wait, I can't copy you the exact
You
one.
Think it would be my junk account or something, but it nothing. It recognizes my email address. It just hasn't sent it to me.
No. What I meant is earlier you mentioned you whitelisted eagle.ru or whatever stuff. That's not where that email is getting sent from. It's the one I sent you. It's reply@digitalcombatsimulator.com.
Okay, let me add that in there then.
Yep.
Man, I need a new VR headset. It's all fucked up.
What happened to it?
There was something that went straight into the lens and damaged So yeah, it's not
the thing. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not unplayable, but it's pretty fucked up.
Yeah, any damage to the lens is never good in a VR head.
Yeah, it's not actually the lens, it's actually the panel.
Yeah, because it focused the sun onto the panel.
Okay, yeah.
It burns the actual screen, yeah. I've heard about that.
Oh god, yeah, that's so bad. Yeah,
Oh no, you're definitely
so
fucked.
Many people. Yeah, I heard that from
There's
so many
nothing
people.
You can do about that as well, just buy a new one, that's about it.
Yeah,
that's why I always keep mine in a box when I never use it or not use it. It's so fast,
yeah.
Super fast.
I'm like, fuck, it's so annoying. But there is no good VR headset out there in terms of. I wanted something with a better resolution and a wider field of view, and then nothing out there.
What do you have right now?
I have the first Oculus Rift CV1.
Honestly, I've heard so much good shit about the Pimax ones. I've been really wanting to try one. Like the five, I think they have a 5K one. It's amazing. Like the field of view is crazy.
Yeah, that
sounds pretty good. I mean, it's had a rough time back when they did their first Kickstarter.
Yeah, the first one they had sucked.
But the ones they offer now, like especially the 8K and the 8K Plus or whatever it's called, 8K Plus I think and 8K, they're really, really good. They even have an option for eye refresh.
I actually had a Pimax 4K, which is the previous generation. That one was pretty bad because you didn't have any positional head tracking.
I wish
you moved your head side to side in the cockpit.
I'll fucking fly. It's a music guy.
I'm trying to figure it out. Just go for it. All right. I'll try it in later.
Okay, I'll see you guys in game.
Oh boy, this is really dark. Okay, what the fuck?
The sun will come up for all.
Chief, turn on the ground power. Copy.
No, I'm trying to press buttons and I forget which one's the light for the... It is like a finger light, left alt L.
remove the wheel chocks.
Copy. Wheel chocks are now removed.
Chief, turn off the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now off.
Bonaparte 1-2, radio check 129.
Bonaparte 1-2, 129 5x5, which advise from register taxi.
Hey, does SRS not work with the JS-17?
Well, dunno.
Bonaparte 1-2, ready to taxi.
I think it doesn't. It's not detecting my game.
Copy that, Bonaparte 1-2, stand by.
And it's definitely installed right, because on my, like, in DCS on my screen it says no radio connected on the top. Connected SRS. Fuck.
What if I want taxi to hold short runway 15? What if I want you cleared your taxi to hold short runway 15?
Yeah. Oh, that fucking sucks. I'm ready anyway.
Yeah, just take off when you're ready to go, man.
Data link and try to use SOS and the frequency.
I'm just instructing the talk to us through Discord.
Alright, guys, taking off from the cat. I already see aircraft, sir. Hey.
Yeah, that's sad. So let's see. We just stay in Discord then, right?
Yeah, that's what I figure.
Yeah, cool, yeah.
It sucks, but I'm sorry.
Yeah. Don't worry, it's still early access. They will probably fix it.
Yeah, I think it's SRS's fault. I mean, I don't know why.
I think the server is updated to 172 or something, and
I'm 1.7.2 here.
It's not affecting
my game.
Are we using Discord?
Yeah, I guess we are.
Yeah, I'm sorry. SRS doesn't seem to work with my JF17 right now. Maybe I did something wrong, but I don't think I did because it worked with other modules.
Yeah, I think we've been having a lot of issues with J17.
Yeah,
recently.
Sorry,
so I think for future mission we probably won't use that anymore. Because the last mission was the same story. At this time, this Discord is now going to be pushed to talk officially.
All right, I see a lot of enemy activity here.
Speaking of enemy activity, I was pre-armed with anti-radiation. Are you taking harm, or should I?
It's however you want. I can go. I can do other. If you wanna grab anti-radiation, it's fine.
I can quickly shut down and grab something else.
No, go ahead. I'll do other stuff. It's fine. I like.
Yeah.
So, are we doing this through Discord now?
Not totally. Just the land-based units, I think, and whatever needs. We could
okay, Method, you're gonna start that sentence from the beginning. Jester just started screaming him. So, was that Method?
So, just stay as usual on SS and I will stay on Discord.
Okay.
Bonaparte, no, I want you. Holy fuck, please.
Please.
Lascar, what's the status, man?
I'm pretty much finished starting up here.
Copy that. Don't get the boys. We're gonna wait for you in here.
All right.
All right, boys. Let's get over here on the runway. Enter runway 15 and let's get ready to take off. Bonaparte 12 still on the left side of the runway, and let's let Medfish take off first. Copy. So let's let Medfish take off.
Good.
Medfish, you let us know when you're taking off. We'll take off and fly formation with you. Because you're slow, it will be easier this way to.
Copy that.
Boozy, 1-1. We'll take off.
Alright, Lascar's texting.
Boozy, 1-1.
Alright, we have 9 banners inbound. We need to chop chop, stay together, and work as a team. Medfish, go. My mirrors are rolling now.
Enfield 1-1. Unable to clear for takeoff. Enfield 1-1. Unable to clear.
Lascar, we're gonna head straight to Sochi, try to keep catch up.
Yeah, go for it.
My radar, I cannot bloody see anything.
Okay, let's go for a right.
I lost you. My radar is not working.
I see a mirage.
Murdoch, you overturned.
Yeah, I'm on your left. Also, I don't have any waypoints. Do you have any bearings?
I just follow the beach north.
Yeah, copy that. Let's just do that.
Okay, what the fuck is that? Can you hang on, Mert? I think my front landing gear is not. What's your speed, Medfish?
Speed is roughly 250. And yes, if I look behind, I see smoke. So you actually got some damage, maybe better damage.
Yeah, I'm gonna. No, my engine smokes. I need. I just need to you to tell me if my you see my front gear. I'm just locking you right now, just so I can get the separation. Do you see my gear in or not?
Yeah, the nose gear is out for sure.
Fuck. What the hell is this?
Yeah, that's weird. Also interesting that the lock kept going although you overtook me and were in front of me. Maybe you got a super.
Well, I can shoot my gun, so. How bad can it be?
Oh, God. But what we could do is we could check if your aft gear comes out and you can do a landing and.
There's a lot of enemies in front.
I had to respond because I had a bug on my aircraft. I'm already taxiing, taking off.
I'm seeing
oh shit, yeah, there's people right here. 9 mile. Fox 3.
Thing exploded like right in front of me.
I'm airborne already. I'm full burns towards you, boys.
I see some flares. That's enemy.
Oh boy, there must be some bombers around.
They're right here.
I'm inside.
Fox.
Guns.
I see you.
So the 2050 is going down.
Are you right, Madfish?
Yes, I'm perfect.
Who is smoking?
That is a enemy SU-2050. There are enemy SU-2050. I just want guns on it.
I got Sam's in here.
There are so many enemies here.
My radar is still fucking warm up, I don't know who is who.
Getting locks from the north. Turning quick self.
Wanna talk to us, man, don't stay quiet there.
Yeah, I'm getting missile launches.
See
left,
another
right.
2050, I'm getting guns on him too.
On for the time being, all as 25.
comes from me.
I hit a missile.
Alright, I have to RTB. Why the fuck am I not chaffing? They got R-77s up in this bitch.
Got it. Ejecting.
There are so many fighters. What the hell? I don't think you realize how, like, my radar... It's retarded. Oh, for fuck's sake, are you serious? I'm hit. We just got strafed. Oh, we're getting strafed here.
Holy monkey. Yep. Yeah, me too. But I was in a hangar for God. Those vultures.
This will be getting tough.
Yeah, I cannot.
Especially for the 2050, yeah.
I cannot take off. I literally cannot take off my witch.
Trying to take off from the taxiway and shoot them down.
Where are the naval guys out?
They never guys doing never shit. Some
are they not coming?
I don't know. They are about. They're about 200 miles from here, fighting their own fight.
Where the fuck are there this many fucking planes here? I mean, we're two fighters here.
I haven't been able to fight yet. And banana just got destroyed.
Yeah.
We don't have.
You should have waited. I mean, no, none of us is up there, so if you see anything...
I can't wait. They're destroying us in the air, like on the ground.
Yeah, it fucking sucks.
I got one of my six.
I think Wolfman got a bit overzealous with, with the amount of play. We can get him. I count five up here, six. Six in the air right above us. Oh, sorry, 7, 8, 9. Count 9. And I have 6 missiles. Eh, never mind, I just got yeeted. I actually got killed through the bunker, that's nice.
Shit's going down here.
Okay, quickly, I will quickly hop into an F-15.
I've got a new strat. I'm hopping into MiG-21.
Oh, nice.
Hey, it's the fastest plane to start up.
Yeah. Also, something just hit my bunker again, and something else crashed into a bunker in front of me.
Alright, taking off now. Fuck's sake, don't take off any shit.
Maybe pick another Mirage.
I spawn with my wheels inside the ground.
You're gonna have to like pier hop and take off from the ground, understand? Because they are picking us up as soon as. Why you don't have any kind of air defense here?
That's a good question.
Yeah, my spawn is screwed. Got cratered.